strain of what is believed to be the only remaining colony of inferiors in America has turned up some new information. The raid was successful, terminating all inferiors inside the U.S. borders. But it is now believed that one may have escaped. Military police are releasing few details, but caution the public to be aware of just how dangerous this individual may be.
Don't worry. I won't hurt you.
But you're an inferior. You don't have a right to live. Help me!
Up the main boardwalk. Look for a white van.
It's okay. You're safe.
Let's go!
Who are you people?
LA Underground. The Extinct. We've heard you'd be heading our way.
So you people really do exist. Extinct isn't just a myth. How many more are there like...
Yourself? Not many. Only about five, and a few Chicanos and Asians. The smell, it'll grow on you. Government thinks this line of sewers is filled with methane, hazardous to humans. Figure all that's down here is rats and turds.
Terrence, welcome to Extinct, Terrence. You don't have to be afraid here.
Alberto, thanks, man.
Welcome to our home. That's Charmaine Givens. She was a newscaster on a local show, and now she's our map reader and keeps up with what's going on around the country. The fellow next to her is Russ Tang, who's a historian by profession. He's her assistant. Over here is Will Givens, Charmaine's husband, who was the chief engineer for the city of Los Angeles, and now he's the one who finds the safest areas for us down here. And over here is Maria. She slipped and fell while lifting some crates. You have to be careful near the water. The darkness plays tricks on your eyes, but you'll get used to it. Over there is Elizabeth, our in-house doctor, who was the chief surgeon at Cedars-Sinai Hospital. Elizabeth is a jack of all trades. And over here is Russ's wife. She had several beauty salons, Now she's one of the helpers when she's in. But she's usually not in, if you know what I mean. And over there is Bobby G. Bobby G is a shortwave radio man, and he keeps us informed of the goings-on above ground. Bobby was one of the biggest music engineers in the business, despite his age. And Hector's Maria's husband. Before the order came about, I was a school teacher for more than 25 years, teaching kids, among other things, to love and respect their fellow man. Some of them did. Some of them didn't.
I'm sorry.
No need to feel sorry about someone else's ignorance. My job now is to operate the generators, coordinate things with what's left of the resistance.
Well, I'm willing to help out any way I can.
I think the first thing you should do is to get a bite to eat. Come over here and relax. Have a seat. I'll be right back.
Why you always get to do this?
Let me talk to him.
No, Vato, this is mine.
Come on.
It's a brother, man. Go on. Let me talk to him.
All right.
Your homes. You see any brothers and sisters out on the streets up there?
No.
Your homes. You see my own boys. Chicano brothers. But your ladies in your stomping grounds.
Mm-mm. Sorry.
Damn.
Excuse me, Terrence. Have you seen any Asians above ground in the last few days?
Mm-mm. No, sorry.
Man, I thought you said your homies were invincible.
Yeah, well, I thought you brothers were invincible too, Wesley.
Still coming in?
I mean, you're full of shit.
Ignore them. They don't mean any harm. They're just not used to company. You must have really been exhausted. You slept over a day.
That long?
That long. I'll get you something to eat. And then we're gonna see if we could try to get you some work. You used to be a writer, didn't you?
Used to be.
We've been needing to have someone to record a struggle down here. Keep some sort of journal. You interested?
Doesn't sound like much work, but sure.
You'd be surprised.
Music. It's always broken down barriers. Love, color, even hate, man. People just listen to that music, it's gonna happen.
So please spare me, yes, sir? Why do you think they got us down in this stinking hole to begin with? The stinking order wants to kill anyone with a different skin color than they own. And your music, yes, sir? We'll do shit to change that.
Man, people just listen to the music, man, it's gonna happen.
Let me get off it, yes, sir? Elvis Presley himself wouldn't change their minds. You step out of this hole, you and their vatoms.
Watch me.
You really need to start taking it easy, Charmaine. Let Will store the food. You're 6 months pregnant.
He hardly even knows I exist. If I don't lift it off the floor, the rats will get to it.
There, it's okay. Just stay off your feet for a day or so.
I can manage.
Bobby G just went outside. Somebody needs to go out and get him.
I'll go.
A song. A song to show you that I'm no different from you or your children. Our ancestors, they had problems, but they worked them out.
Disgusting animal. Shut him up!
We'll work them out just as they did. Just listen to the words of the song.
Jesus. We can't afford to lose you two. Talking.
Inferior.
Why doesn't he just go away?
He will.
Watch.
Hey.
Hey.
I thought you might like some company. Or maybe you just got sick of the smell down there. Look. What you did today was brave. It's the first time I've seen anyone risk their lives so quickly for another. There wasn't anything you could have done to save him. Bobby dreamed that his music would somehow change the world since the day he arrived here. Well, maybe now his dream has come true for him.
How long have you been down here?
Just a few months. I was smuggled in from the San Diego Underground just hours before it was raided. Alberto has moved this location several times now. Always one step ahead of them. He says he has a good suerte. Luck?
Yeah.
They haven't gotten to him yet.
What is that?
This is the ultimate family heirloom. It's a piece of my great-great-grandfather's slave chain. It's been in the family now for 150 years. He kept the first piece of chain that was broken when he was free. It symbolized the freedom of my family. Now they are truly free.
This my heirloom.
An island?
It's not just an island, it's Libertad. It's an uninhabited island.
In the South Pacific, yes, I know. I read the book before it was banned, but that's fiction.
No, it isn't. Libertad exists.
But how do you know that?
Because I wrote the book. Several decades ago, a fishing boat took those, along with several others of an uninhabited island. And after briefly exploring it, they made a stop at Guam, and they were lost at sea. No charts or records existed until a few years ago. A salvage team located the wreck and managed to bring up the captain safe. The brother on board kept those for himself until he gave them to me before he was hung in San Francisco.
So the island is still uninhabited?
It's the only place I know on this planet where we can be left alone. Nobody has to know we live there.
You should tell this to Alberto.
When the time is right, sure.
You know, looking at the sky, the moon and the stars all look white. But in reality, the whole universe is full of color.
No.
But it's your heirloom.
It doesn't have to be just mine.
Thank you.
justifiably so, my black and Hispanic brothers and sisters, if you keep presenting yourselves as violent and cold-blooded killers of your own kind, it's only a matter of time before that's ingrained in everybody's mind. And guess who disappears? But is it justifiably so? My Asian, Arabic, and South Pacific brothers and sisters, if you keep putting economics ahead of your own people, it's only a matter of time before the so-called ruling class looks at you as unequal. And guess who disappears? Is it justifiably so? I don't think so. It was fear that led to our situation. An economy that was in ruins, a desperate struggle to find an easy and logical solution. This led to the rise of the order, a political movement that blamed the weakest elements of society. When they came for the immigrants, I did not help. When they came for the poor, I did not help. When they came for my neighbor, I did not help. And when they came for me, there was no one left that could help. We have the right to live just as much as they do. They can kill and destroy the flesh, but they can't break the spirit.
Come on, girl, let's go. Come on, you can't push, girl. Come on now.
Day 97, and life has been nearly unbearable living in a hole like rats. However, today is a very special and happy one because, for once, life, instead of death, is the order of the day. Day 133, and I finally realize what that old saying, from the dirt comes the rose, means. For who would have thought that I would have found the love of my life in the nightmare of my life? Regardless of a man's economical, political, or social situation, when a child is born to him, everything becomes minor in comparison.
Come on, come on, come on. Push, Liz, push.
Would everyone please stop doing what you're doing for a minute and gather around? I have something very important to say. People, someone may have allowed our whereabouts to be discovered. Now, I just got an alarm from Chuck saying that there are rumors above ground that the government suspects we're in the tunnel. Someone has been careless. Very careless. They've risked everything, including our future. I guess that's all I have to say.
It's okay.
Along with the shortage of food supply, there is now a feeling among the group that our time in the tunnel is also running short.
What the hell are you doing?
Russ, this is not what it looks like.
Then tell me, Will, what is it?
This is food I've been saving instead of eating.
In that case, you won't mind if I tell the rest of the group.
I don't think they'd understand.
It's been you who's going above ground to steal food, isn't it? Why?
Russ.
Why? You put everyone at risk, including your baby. I hope you can live with yourself.
You dirty son of a bitch. No. Now I understand why you've been disappearing from the group. You're jeopardizing everybody, including me and your baby. You don't give a damn about anyone besides yourself. Let me go, you let me go.
Don't do anything.
Let me go.
Day 420. Hope springs life eternal. Or so they say. I've begun to tell the others about Libertad and the promise that may await them. We don't have much time, but if we're going to have any chance at all, we need to take it now. Nothing's worse than having your dreams destroyed. Well, nothing except maybe not having any dreams at all. I think we should move a little faster.
I agree. Everybody listen up. We're getting to the island, we gotta get a move on. And everybody please remember our plan. If anyone has to split from the group, we'll meet back at the boat. Dock 7. Take care of your family.
What are you gonna do?
Everything's gonna be okay. Come on, let's go.
If you get separated, look for an old couple with a baby stroller.
Go on!
Damn.
Hey, come on. What about Chuck
Russ.
And Elliot? We're cut off from the contact point.
Let's get moving. We don't have time for this.
Oh!
love you. I know you can do it.
Please, put your baby in here.
We'll make sure he gets to the island.
Please, we're part of the resistance.
Store.